understanding the profession and why it's important to do something with this problem. Because, for three reasons. For a social reason, because we want to give equal opportunities to everybody. For an economic reason, because companies need talents and they need to get talents from the whole population. And for an environmental reason, because the problems are so huge that we need a creative, diverse force to solve them.
The main aim of EU Gaming is to improve gender balance in informatics at all levels. We do this by being a network. We are a network of European colleagues who are trying to improve gender balance in their countries and in their research communities throughout these 4 years that the project is active.
EU Gain covers representatives from 38 European countries. It is funded by the COAST program and allows researchers to set up their interdisciplinary networks in Europe and beyond.
EUGAIN is organized into 5 working groups, where the first one is looking into the situation from high school to university, second working group from bachelor master studies to PhD, the third one from PhD to professors, and then in the fourth working group we are looking at the cooperation with industry and society, and in the fifth at strategy and dissemination.
EUGAIN is an open, interdisciplinary and growing network welcoming academics, practitioners and relevant stakeholders to contribute to the activities of EUGAIN Work Plan.
If you want in our Twitter and Facebook account.
So the pandemic teach us to be flexible. And today, when I learned that this seminar should not be hybrid, but only virtual, I decided to change the order of my slides and to start from the future, not from the past. And now you have seen a video about EUGAIN. The same video is available at our site, eugain.eu, if you should come later. And I want to tell you which EUGAIN that I want to invite you in. So if you are not part of our network, for the time being, we have approximately 100 people coming from 38 countries participating in our network. If you are not already part of the network, you can go on the website and apply to enter one of the 5 working groups. Then, if you are most interesting for us, if you are a PhD student or a young researcher, you are invited to apply to attend the first winter school about research in gender equality. It will be held in Trondheim in Norway in the week of the 8th of March, in 3 months from now. And if you apply and if you will, and virtual grants that are an excellent opportunities for young interested in doing research at the intersection between computer science and gender, to visit one of the many sites, particular to visit me at NTNU and do research and write papers, collect data about this, be allocated from people coming from the inclusiveness target countries that are approximately half of the countries. That EUGAIN is a network, is open, it has lasted for 1 hour network. So if either if you are, hopefully if you get approved a workshop at the most precise engineering, the deadline for submitting is 14th of January. From my blog, letiziajaccheri.org that you have seen in the call of this seminar, you will get the URL of the workshop, so you can see there how to submit questions. If you need suggestion, please ask me. I will be happy to be a short one or a long one. I'm not sure for being the host of the ACM Women Encourage Conference in 2023. The conference was in Rome. Our colleague from La Sapienza was able to get a lot of sponsors, a lot of fellowship. I hope I and my team will do as well as the Italian team did in 19. And this again means that for young people who are willing to work for diversity in informatics, there will be fellowships. If you go on the website of my group, the big conference, but this is not interested in cooperating with us, we will be very happy for this. It's almost 57 years old. I am a mother, a teacher, so I know very well that people don't do what I say you should do. So my advice, you should take, I need to give some advice, and later I will tell you my story and you disagree. So if you want to do something for the gap in informatics, for the gender gap and the diversity gap in informatics, the first thing you have to do, you must know your numbers and set your goals. It's almost trivial, but everything is research. We have to have goal and we have to measure how we achieve our goal. We tend to focus more on the recruitment than on the dropout. So my advice is that you should keep and empower the female you have. And the third advice, something that we have just said, for example, how to make hackathon friendly, so that try to open up from the binary gender gap to something more complex, more diverse. So if you want to do something, we should look for funds, we should look for connections, we should establish project, we should celebrate when we have some achievement, we should document all this research, because if we see what we are doing as a feeling and we are able to measure success, professional and effectful way. Towards the end, and I can start my presentation from the beginning, question than just me talking as a monologue. If I should not finish all the slides, is no problem because the slides are on the web page. So please, if you have questions, write them in the chat and Susanna or Stefano will interrupt me. Yes, so I am more and more interested in this topic of gender issues in computer science, and I see this topic everywhere. I give you an example. When I cooperate with institutions, when I see the scene, it's perfectly balanced. We don't know if Cherubino was a boy or a girl, at least I don't know. My university where I have my PhD from, the Politecnico di Torino, recently, almost 1 year ago, they changed Minerva, the goddess of peaceful defense. I think this is we have is not a role model for you. But anyway, I have my story. I have only one story that started at the University of Pisa. My supervisor and first great role model in research and academic life was and is Vincenzo Andriola. And when I started work as a programmer in the TechSEAL at the time, if you are not so good that you can get a grant for the US, Professor Reda Conradi was a pioneer in software engineering research, and not only, he was already in late 80s aware of the gender gap. And I remember he was asking me, how many girls are you in Pisa? How many boys? I didn't understand why he was interested in this question. And he really passed to me this interest, and not least in 2002, he managed to get one professorship in software engineering for NTNU that was targeted for women, and I get that position. So I have a professorship that was a professorship more than I was earning in 2002. But anyway, I'm motivated students from the University of Pisa to be a student. Each year I have exchange students. They are very happy and they get to work with companies, they get to work with Norwegian students, and they get to work with our teacher team that is truly multinational and gender balanced. In fact, now we are even a bit too many girls in my team than boys, but this is a luxury problem. So, professor and as a researcher, female and 3 male, supervised 20 PhD students, 10 female and 10 male, and I have been opponents for 20 PhD defense, 10 female and 10 males, but unfortunately I do quite bad for postdoc because I have been supervising 7 and only 1 female. And NTNU is part of the ERSIM network together with CNR. A PhD at the end of your path, or if you are because I wish to do something with this statistic. So when I go around and give this presentation, I change. And tonight, I must admit, I was awake a couple of hours to speak to you. Excellent people from the University of Pisa is CEP. And now I am here in Barbaricina. I am 500 meters from the, maybe 300, from the place here in Via del Capannone where CEP was built. And when I go for my walk, exhibition about the interaction between the human and the technology. And when the young girls, what are you doing? I say, okay, I try to understand the relation. Many years ago, I wrote this book, Quorum, a Computer, that is translated in Norwegian, and now you cannot buy anymore, but you can download from my website. And still also on my website, there is this small book, Tappetina, that I wrote first, including Chinese and Greek and Spanish and other and Norwegian, of course, by my students. And this story is about a young girl who has been a researcher and is now helping other women to succeed with their software engineering. And through these projects, we developed together with my students many things. That was a game that was made to make people aware of how difficult it is to produce water in the different countries. So that game was made in a context of art and technology, but that Horizon application, a project that was called Socrat Informatics. I must admit that was 2016. I didn't know about the UN goals. I learned on the job by working on this project, and by learning the UN goals, I understood that these activities that I was doing almost like a hobby at the intersection between gender and computer science, they could be framed as a work that we do under the UN goal 5, that is achieve gender equality and empower all women and girls. So if you look at this goal, it's very well formulated. It says that when we work for gender equality, we do it for social reason, to give to everybody the same opportunities, but we also do for economic growth and development. And I will try in this short time that we have to give you some examples, some motivation that this relation that the UN goals formulate, like it's proven, can be explored as a kind of research question. So I, in the beginning, for those who saw the small video about Eugain, I start by saying that when we work for gender equality, we do for social, economic, and environmental reason. If on the website of the Commission, of the European Commission, there are a lot of resources that explains very well these issues. And there is also a toolkit for developing gender equality plans. and for developing presentation like the one that I am giving to you that can be targeted toward the audience that you want to address. For example, if you want to talk, there are people who think and who say that gender equality is something that is opposed to excellence. When you read these documents by the Commission, there are very good arguments to say that if you work for gender and diversity in general, you will improve, you will achieve excellence. Is not something that is either or, it's something that it is an and. There are also very good examples about the disadvantages of not thinking about gender when producing AI systems, when producing software system. And for sure you have heard this example about the AI recruiting technology, that if it is developed and trained on data set predominantly trained on men, it will reproduce itself and will not recruit women. Example from my own research, because again, I have retargeted my research in software engineering to be mainly addressing gender issues, and software engineering can be explained very quickly in three sentences. In software engineering, people decide the requirement, people develop solution for the people, and people interact with system. So it is in the team that decide the requirement and produce. So engineering meets AI, it becomes even more tell the computer how it should, the computer system how it should over and over again. It's very important for gender balance, and again, there can be many axes, ability, disabilities, and many other considerations that we apply when we test our technologies. Here, I only give some. This project is a collaboration between Elisa Rubegni from UK and Monica Landoni from the University. We work for a technology for children to remove gender stereotypes. Children tell stories. Another project to the workshop, they say, full PhD thesis about this experience that in the end of my presentation as references. So, Susanna, do we have any questions in the chat? No.
No, no.
Okay, then I go ahead.
No questions.
Okay, but then I can go to say, this is how I would like to do more of the students enrolling in informatics are male, percent are male, and the same for PhD with only some exception for country like Bulgaria, Romania, Estonia, and Turkey that are doing better than the average European situation. I don't know which numbers you have at the University of Pisa. Maybe somebody has told me, but I don't remember, or you have not told me. And I am very curious to know your number. And a number that is really scaring. We don't think that it should be like this in 2021, that in Europe for engineering and technology, only 15% of the full professor positions are female. So there is the so-called talent gap, and something that is very important to use when we talk to the companies, at least in Norway, I have used this argument with success, that European employers say they face difficulties in finding the right people with the right qualifications. So we go to the companies and say, okay, you want more talents, please help us to get more girls, because then you will recruit not from 50% of the population, you will recruit from the whole population. And now I want to show you a video about a project that we have been running at NTNU since the 90s. And so, yes, I hope that while looking at the video, you can have some reflection and write something in the chat for me. So please have a look at this video if I manage to start it. sorry. So good